This is from True Pundit. Exclusive: Bill Gates negotiated $100 billion contact tracing deal with Democratic congressman, sponsor of bill, 6 months before coronavirus pandemic. The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation helped negotiate who would score a $100 billion government-backed contact tracing contract in August 2019, 6 months before the pandemic arrived in the United States and 4 months before it swept through China. The shocking revelations were unveiled on the Thomas Paine podcast and the More Paine show on Patreon by the two investigators who blew the whistle on the massive Clinton Foundation tax fraud during a congressional hearing in 2018. John Moynihan and Larry Doyle testified in Congress detailing the fraud and schemes utilized by the Clintons to avoid paying up to $2.5 billion in federal taxes. The investigative duo, in their first interview since that bombshell congressional testimony, revealed to Paine that representatives from the Gates Foundation met with U.S. Congressman Bobby L. Rush at a sit-down in Rwanda, East Africa, in mid-August 2019 to hash out who would score the windfall from a government contact tracing program. And just last month, 9 months after the meetings with the Gates Foundation in Rwanda, Rush, a Democrat from Illinois, introduced the $100 billion H.R. 6666, the COVID-19 testing, reaching, and contacting everyone, TRACE Act. Rush's bill would establish a program run by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, for national coronavirus testing and contact tracing. Paine has since learned Congressman Rush traveled to Rwanda with his spouse from August 12th to 19th, 2019 to take part in talks and a week-long event underwritten by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and the Rockefeller Brothers Fund. But how can you negotiate the byproducts of monitoring a pandemic 6 to 7 months before the outbreak of the virus even happens?
Nice to meet you. Hope you guessed my name. Oh, yeah. But what's confusing you is just the nature of my game.
The World Health Organization recommended forcibly removing family members from their homes and putting them in quarantine.
Now we need to go and look in families to find those people who may be sick and remove them and isolate them in a safe and dignified manner.
Queen Elizabeth seemed to be echoing this idea to the UK.
It reminds me of the very first broadcast I made in 1940, helped by my sister. We as children spoke from here at Windsor to children who had been evacuated from their homes and sent away for their own safety. Today, once again, many will feel a painful sense of separation from their loved ones. But now as then, we know deep down that it is the right thing to do.
Bill Gates has been pushing the idea of tracking people with digital tattoos, and Microsoft was recently granted patent number 060606 for a cryptocurrency surveillance system connected to the human body. Now enter H.R. 6666 to authorize the Secretary of Health and Human Services to award grants to eligible entities to conduct diagnostic testing for COVID-19 and related activities such as contact tracing through mobile health units and, as necessary, at individuals' residences and for other purposes. On May 1st of 2020, Illinois Congressman Bobby Rush introduced H.R. 6666. This act is essentially setting up a nationwide contact tracing and quarantine program run by Big Pharma. Section 2, COVID-19 testing and contact tracing using mobile health units, will allow Bill Gates loyalist Alex Azar and the CDC to fund eligible entities to conduct tests, trace and monitor the contacts of infected individuals, and to support the quarantine of these contacts via mobile health units. Who are the eligible entities qualified to receive this funding? Health centers, nonprofit organizations, high schools, and anyone else that Alex Azar deems eligible. The amount of taxpayer dollars being asked for to trace the public and force quarantines is $100 billion for 2020 alone, and whatever may be necessary as long as the emergency period continues. For InfoWars.com, this is Greg Reese.